Muhammad. My name is Nara. We meet again in this short video in which I'm going to talk to you about two things very essential to a sword, very technical, but it's important that you understand these two concepts in the sword. Okay, the first thing is the point of balance. And secondly, is known as the point of percussion, or the sweet spot. Alright, point of balance is basically straightforward. It's pretty straightforward. Okay, I have here a Jenawi Sukma. Point of balance means that it is the point where the sword is balanced between the hilt and the blade. So that is roughly the point of balance for the sword, which is about, I would say, 4.5 to 5 inches from the hilt. Okay, what is the importance of the point of balance? The point of balance on the sword determines what kind of sword it is, or what is it used for. For example, a sword that has a point of balance closer to the hilt is normally an infantry weapon, okay, meaning that it is for foot combat. It could be one on one, it could be one against many, but the combatant will usually be on foot. And this is because the closer the point of balance gets to the hilt, the sword becomes more nimble. So you can move it around very fast. Okay. What happens when the point of balance goes down the blade? Okay, let's say the point of balance is more towards the end of the blade. Let's say it's like 10 or 12 inches down the blade, meaning that the blade will be heavier towards the end. It will feel heavier towards the end. Okay, normally this kind of sword, which is heavier towards the end, they are usually cavalry weapons if they are long enough. In case of shorter weapons with the weight that goes towards the end, meaning that this is more of a cut-centric sword. So the technique of the wielder is more into cutting and, I hate to say it, but hacking. Maybe against armored opponents or opponents using the shield, perhaps. Okay. We find this kind of balance in execution swords. Swords that are used for executing people. So the blade is generally heavier towards the end because you want a very firm and stable cut in order for the executioner to perform his duties better. Alright. Basically, that is the point of balance. So, point of balance determines what kind of sword it is, how it is used. Next, we have the point of percussion. So, what is the point of percussion? Alright. It's very important to know that in a sword, you do not strike anywhere along the blade, just anywhere. No, there is a certain part or a certain place where it is most ideal for you to cut. Okay, that sweet spot, so to say, is known as the point of percussion. Now, unlike the point of balance, point of percussion is more or less fixed at about 1/3 to 1/4 of towards the end of the blade. So how do we determine the point of percussion on the blade? Okay, there are many ways, several ways, some mechanical, some electronic. But the easiest way for you to know where the point of percussion is to hold the blade this way, okay, hold it by the handle that way, and then you gently tap along the blade. See, as you tap, you can see that the blade will wobble until it reaches one point where there is minimal or sometimes no wobbling at all. So for this blade, it's about there. If I tap it toward the end, you can see the blade wobbling. Okay, but not there. So that means this sword, the point of balance, the point of percussion is somewhere here. So if I were to cut with this sword, I will need to get my target about here. So if I were to cut further down, it will not be as effective as that point there. So this is the strongest point for a cut, the most suitable point, and that is known as the point of percussion. You can cut all the way toward the end, of course, but it will be just a superficial cut. So the cut will not be as powerful as if it was made here along this area called the point of percussion. Some people call it the sweet spot. So if your cutting goes wrong, it is possible that you're not cutting it where you're supposed to cut. Okay, so that is all for today. I hope my short video has given you some information, useful information. And until we meet again in the next video, I'm Kunara. Salam hormat. Cheers, folks. Stay home. Stay safe.